Hello guys, welcome to the WebAppick channel. In this video, we'll learn how to include and exclude product variations from the product feed. So without further ado, let's jump in and learn how exactly we can do this. Right now in CTX feed, let's go ahead and create a feed. Click on new feed. Country United States is fine. Let's use custom template 1. Let's say variation 1, keep it at XML, and under include variations, you see all these different options: variable product parents, all variations, default variations, first variation, last variation, variable plus variations. We're going to talk about all these different options that you have. For now, let's go ahead and save this feed at all variations. Let's go update and generate this feed. Now, let's go back to our product page and ensure that we actually have a variable product in our page. Click on products. In our product page, let's go ahead and check if we have any variable products. I'm going to go variable products and I'm going to filter it by that. As you can see right here, t-shirt is a variable product. Let's scroll down and let's look at all the different variations. As you can see, we have three different colors available: blue, green, and red. And every single color has three different sizes available to it: small, medium, and large. This is perfect. Let's go ahead and use this and create our feed. Now back in our feed, let's go ahead and check all the different variable options that we have. The first option we'll be looking at is all variations. Let's click on that. This option is fairly straightforward. You should be able to see all the different 9 variables that we have for t-shirts. So let's go ahead, update and generate this feed, and let's have a look. There you go guys, as expected, we can see all the different variables included in our feed. We can see the red, small, medium, large, blue with the different sizes as well, and also at the same time we can see the green and all the respective sizes as well. So this is showing all the different variables that we have available under our variable product t-shirt. Let's go back to our feed and change the setting and see what it would look like afterwards. Let's go back into our feed. The next variable option that we'll be looking at is basically variable products parents. Sometimes we only want the main product to show up or the parent product. In this case, for us, it's t-shirts and not the variables. If we want that to happen, we want to choose this variable product in bracket parents. Now the price is going to be picking up. You can choose from here if it's the first variation price, the maximum variation price, or the minimum variation price. All the prices for the different variations are set up right here. It will be set up under all the different variations. You can also choose which product quantity is going to show up. It's going to show the first variation quantity, maximum, minimum, or the sum of all variation quantity. For now, I'm just going to keep it at first. Let's do that. Let's go ahead, update and generate this feed. Let's have a look at it right now. As you can see guys, in our feed right now, we don't see all the different variations we have for the t-shirt. We can only see the t-shirt, the parent product, showing up. And this is exactly what we have expected. Let's go back to our feed and try a different option. Let's go back in our feed. And the next variable option that we're looking at is the default variation. Let's choose that. Now for the default variation, for this to work, you need to make sure that under your variable product, you have the default variation chosen. Right now, I have nothing chosen. As you can see under the variations, there's no default color, no default size that has been chosen. Let's say the default variation I wanted to show up is the green color, and I want this to be the size, let's say medium. Let's say this is our most sold product and I want this to show up in our feed as our default variation. Let's go ahead and save it. Perfect. Now let's go back to our feed and update and generate it. Now let's have a look. There you go guys, as expected, we can see the variation green color and the size medium showing up in our feed, and none of the other variations are showing up because this is the default variation. So now you guys know how to use the default variation option. Let's go ahead and look at the other options that we have available. Let's jump back into our feed. The next two options that we have are very straightforward, which is the first variation and the last variation. If we choose first variation, under our product, whatever the first variation is showing up right here is what's going to show up in our feed. So let's test it out. Let's update and generate this feed. Let's have a look. As you can see, since our first variation was the blue and the size small, that's the only variation is showing up in our feed. Now let's go test out the last variation. Now back in our feed, let's go ahead and change this to last variation. Let's check what the last variation is, which is the red and the size L. So I'm expecting to see the red color t-shirt with the size L. There you go, perfect. As expected, we can see the red t-shirt of the size L, since this is our last variation. Last but not the least, let's look at the last variable option that we have. Last but not the least, the last option we have is variable plus variations. Once again, when you choose that, you get to choose which price is going to show, the first variation price, max, or the minimum variation price. Same goes for the quantity as well. I'll keep them at first. Right now, when I choose this product, I expect to see all the different variations and also the parent product. Let's go ahead and update and generate this feed. Time to take a look. There you go. As expected, we can see all the different variations showing up. Red with the different sizes, blue with the different sizes, green with all the different sizes. And at the end, we can also see our parent product, which is t-shirt. There you go, guys. Now you know how you can include or exclude product variations from your product feed. If you have any questions or issues, you're welcome to reach out to us at support@webappick.com. I hope you guys found this video useful. Please leave a like and subscribe to this channel for more videos like this. I hope everybody has a good day. Thank you very much.